Hello and welcome to my kitchen. My name is Patricia and I want to share with you my top 10 favorite kitchen hacks to save you both time and money in the kitchen. So let's get started. Hack number one, multi-batch your favorite recipe. If you and your family find a recipe that you really enjoy, why not make multiples of it, double, triple, or even quadruple the recipe? It will only add about 20 minutes to your cooking time, and you have to do the dishes anyway, so why not just double it? So for example, my favorite pancake mix comes from Canadian Living magazine, and when I fill this container, it's 7 times the recipe. Why this is better than to buy store-bought is I know every ingredient that's in it, and it's much cheaper to make your own. So ditto my marinara sauce. I double the recipe, and once the sauce is cool, I fill half a Ziploc bag full of the sauce, lay it flat on a cookie sheet, and freeze it, and it's ready for storing. Hack number two, save your vegetable scraps for stock. When you're preparing vegetables, you'll always have tops and tails and some skins left over. So I always freeze mine in bags such as this. And when I have 2 bags full, that's when I know to make stock. Here's my 19-liter stock pot. And when I have my 2 bags full, I empty them in the pot, fill the pot with cold water, add some peppercorns and some allspice berries and some fresh parsley, and simmer it for an hour for a vegetable stock. Or if you're going to be adding bones, you can simmer it much, much longer for 3 to 3.5, maybe even 4 hours. So what can you use stock for? Of course, soup is the go-to, but it's also great for gravies, for cooking your rice. And I would never even think of making risotto without a homemade stock. The advantage of making your homemade stock is that you're using up your vegetable ends, plus there's no salt in it. So when you are making your recipe, you can salt it accordingly. Hack number three, make tomato paste balls. Yes, you heard me correctly. Whenever you find a recipe that requires 1 or 2 tablespoons of tomato paste, I'm always frustrated with what to do with the rest of the tomato paste that's left in the can. So I devised this trick where I just put blobs of the tomato paste on a cookie sheet and freeze it. And then once it's frozen, I keep it in a bag like this. So they're handy. You can just pull them out when you need them. They're great to add to your soup stock, to your sauces, or anytime you just need a tablespoon of tomato paste, you can just throw it in the pot and it will melt as needed. Hack number four, make shaker lids for your spice blends. I find that if you make your own seasoning mixes, it's not full of ingredients that you don't want in your cooking, and it also makes your cooking unique. So I always make my own fajita seasoning, I make my own tomato salt, and I always have cinnamon sugar on hand. But what I find really helpful is to double lid them. So for example, we have the regular lid, but then underneath it, I also have a shaker lid. By the way, tomato salt is terrific on popcorn, but it absolutely sings on fried eggs. You can find loads of recipes online for this as well. And fajita seasoning, same thing. Some guests just want to sprinkle a little bit on their fajitas, but if you're doing other cooking, you might want to take a tablespoon or so. So this way, I have the choice. Hack number five, put herbs in glass jars instead of in the fridge. Treat your herbs like they're flowers. If you put them in a vase or a glass and fill the glass with water and put it on a sunny windowsill, it will last you much longer than if they are just stored in the refrigerator, in Tupperware, in a plastic bag, or what have you. Treat them like flowers so you're changing the water every second day. They will last you an incredibly long time. Plus, being on the windowsill, you're staring at them all the time and you're much more likely to use them. You don't forget about them because you're seeing them every day. Hack number six, label your Tupperware. I know it takes a few extra minutes, but if you label your Tupperware, not only will you find that you have less product that you're throwing out at the end of the week, but your family members will know what's in those containers. So just to have this in the fridge, who knows what's in it? but because I've labeled it, everyone can see that there's Parmesan in here. Hack number 7, make your own salad dressing. It's very easy to do, and unlike purchasing salad dressing, where the first or second ingredient is usually water, you won't be paying for water. And think of all the plastic bottles you're saving from the landfill when you do so. All you need to remember is the ratio 1:3, one part acid to 3 parts oil. That you can play around with both acid and oil. For example, lemon is the go-to for the acid, but why not try grapefruit? It makes a nice change. And of course, there's many, many vinegars on the market. You can play around with your vinegar combination as well. This particular salad dressing we like very much. It is half grapeseed oil and half extra virgin olive oil, and it's delicious. It will save you time, and you can make infinite varieties that you can't get in the grocery store. If you want a creamier salad dressing, all you need to do is add a tablespoon or so of Dijon mustard. You can use mayonnaise. You can use yogurt, creme fraiche. And if you want to cut the acid a little bit, you can add a teaspoon of maple syrup and even the last dregs of your jam jar. Raspberry jam is really nice. So is apricot jam. And no one will know there's jam in the vinaigrette. Hack number 8, decant frequently used ingredients to smaller containers. You're already doing this with your sugar bowl, so why not do it with your flour and oils too? I have some flour in this jar. I find it really useful if I only need a tablespoon for a gravy, or if I'm rolling some dough out and I just need to sprinkle my board. Why drag that big canister out when I can just grab a little bit from here? Same with my olive oil. I buy it in 3-liter jugs. Sometimes if I just need a tablespoon in a frying pan, I don't risk putting too much in the frying pan at once if I decant it, and I can just take it from here. Hack number 9 is put your onions in your fridge to prevent tears. I actually have 3 tips for you to prevent tears when you cut an onion. 1 is use a very sharp knife. Number 2, try not to cut the stem end if you can avoid it. And if you are going to use the full onion, on a day that you're going to do batch cooking, for example, I would recommend that you put the onions in the fridge for 1 to 2 hours before you use them. The cold air relaxes the acid in the onion, making you less likely to cry. Don't store your onions in the fridge, though, because they will go soft and moldy. Hack number 10, make your own laundry pre-treatment solution. This is easy to do and it works extremely well. All you need is clear and colorless dish soap and some baking soda. There's no measurement involved. All you need to do is wet the soiled clothing, make a paste using these two, rub them together, rub them onto the wet clothing, and let them soak for 5 to 10 minutes, and then launder as usual. This is an excellent combination for taking out bike chain oil. It's great for grass stains, and it's also really great for cooking grease. And it's very easy on the environment too. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate your time.